So I was just recording a video about the forum. Okay, so if you haven't signed up for the forum, sign up now. So let's open a crazy Talk Animator. Here it is. Okay, today I want to do a quick video about how to animate just about anything in Crazy Talk Animator 3. Okay, so let's find something to animate. Let's go to the internet and let's type game or something. Images. What can we animate? Okay, let's try this to cute characters. Okay, let me just bring them to Le Photoshop. Le Adobe Photoshop. Everyone loves Photoshop. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna make this a 1280 by 720. Let's see. I'm gonna paste the two cute characters. Okay, I'm going to use the cat, and I think I could have done this in faster than cropping the image. Alright, let me see if I can make that background. Seems like a very easy background to make. It just has stripes. Let's make the stripes first, I guess. Let's see. It's blue. Now, a quick way to make stripes. Let's see, how can we make stripes very quickly? There we go. Let's copy this. Merge it. Copy it. Merge it. Copy it. Every time it doubles. Now the floor. Oops. The floor. The floor is three colors like this. Maybe I can just copy this. Oh, I didn't have to. And there is our hardwood floor. Wow, that was a very lazy way to make a picture. This does have a background there. I think I lost my other character there. So let me export this as a PNG. Maybe under animation. Call this a LeCat. I'm gonna export the background as well. Call the background Le Background. Le Big Mac. See, let's import our background. It wants to add bones to it, but I don't want to add bones to my background. I usually like my backgrounds without bones. Unless you have to. Now, you can import this as a background if you wanted to, but I want to do it this way, just because we can. Okay, there is our background. Let's import the cat. Where is the cat? There, let's add some bones for the cat. We're gonna make this super simple. One bone here. And let me see, one here and one over here. Wow. Let me preview this. You can see that this works right away. I don't know, maybe I can add more bones to this. One here, and one here. Maybe three. Okay. Preview this again. And that seems a lot better. Let's add a couple of pins at the bottom here, so the bottom is not going to move. Preview it. Okay, I don't know, that's sort of not working. I'm gonna add more pins at the bottom. Add a few of those. Let me just check the wireframe. I'm gonna add so many pins there that he won't be able to move at all. That's a lot better. I don't think you have to add that many pins, okay? I don't know what happened that time. Okay, so let's go to our scene, and here is our already rigged cat. Okay, let me just animate him quickly. Let's animate the cat. Put him outside. Bring out my timeline. And let's go to frame 10, and let's bring the cat out. See? Play it. That works. Maybe stretch this to frame 20. On frame 23, let's select the bones. Let's put a keyframe here. And he's gonna bounce his head right here. Try it out. It sort of works. Okay. Now we can make the head bounce the other way. Try it out. It sort of works. Let's see, bounce the other way, not too much, the other way, basically every 3 frames. Alright, let's see how that looks. Let me loop this at somewhere around here, play it. And that's not too bad. Let's play that again. And not too bad. Not too bad. Let's play it again. Maybe we can add a sound effect to this. Let's go find a sound effect. Spring sound effect. Free sound effects. Try it out. Download it. Ah, you had to sign up for it. Sparkman email. Amazing. Sparkman. Download now. And here is our sound effect. Okay. So let's play our sound. Say it's somewhere around here. Let's insert our sound effect. Go to create sound. There's our sound. Let's play this back again. I think we should bring it back a little more. Sound 1. Let's play it. Maybe put it a couple of frames before it does the head bounce. Because there's a little delay on the sound effect. Let's see. Alright, so let me just play this back again. So let's export this for YouTube. Okay, so let's render this. Let's go to the render. And I'm going to set this to MP4. Now I'm going to leave the video quality at 8. And I usually render it at 1280 by 720. So I'm going to render from frame 1 to 77. Let's see, let's export this. I'm going to export this as a LeCat. Exporting. It actually renders very quickly. So let's open the file. And there it is. Ready for the YouTube. If you don't have a Crazy Talk Animator, there is a link down in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.